Hi, this is my review of When the Moon Hangs Low, a gothic action role-playing game. This role-playing game takes inspiration from various video games and literary sources, such as Bloodborne, Darkest Dungeon, and Berserk. In this role-playing game, the players participate as characters that are accursed. They have had a very close encounter with the supernatural. This has marked them to the point that they are now both blessed and cursed. So you will fight many dangerous creatures in the darkest corners of an extremely dangerous city. You will see as your ladies and gentlemen of the night will be consumed by their curse if they are not careful. Their strength lies in their own weakness. If they succumb to the rigors of their mark, they may end up losing their souls. Now, let's talk about the quality of the PDF. The quality is great. Everything is well written and explained. The document is fully bookmarked and hyperlinked. The graphic design looks stylish and somewhat minimalistic at the same time. You have awesome looking illustrations. They are in black and white. Their aesthetic style is similar to what you would find in a comic book or a graphic novel. And there are also some photorealistic compositions. Perhaps a minor criticism is that the font that is being used, the commas, sometimes look like periods or dots. So if you are using the PDF, make sure that you zoom in if you want to avoid confusions. Overall, the quality is great. Now, let's talk about the contents. Throughout the chapters, you have these pieces of fiction that draw you into the setting. They express the sort of situations and encounters that you would find in a typical session. I think it's great that they do that and they really get you into the mood of the story. When the Moon Hangs Low is a gothic action role-playing game in which the players take on the roles of hunters, people cursed with terrible fates who use their strange powers to hunt down monsters. Set in Harrowmire, a decaying city teetering on the edge of chaos, it is a game of intrigue, investigation, and combat. So you can play all sorts of adventures with this role-playing game. You can focus on combat, on political situations, or on mysteries. Or maybe a single session is a combination of all of those themes or modes of play. So as I mentioned, the game is set in the city of Harrowmire, a decrepit gothic city in the grip of a terrible curse. The world is similar to our own towards the end of the Industrial Revolution in the 1840s. New discoveries are beginning to revolutionize society, but there is still an air of mystery and darkness. Harrowmire is inspired by early Victorian era London, Prague, Paris, and similar cities. It is an imposing and labyrinthine metropolis that reaches into the sky with towering buildings linked by walkways and bridges that crisscross and overlap. Once, people flocked to Harrowmire to seek their fortune in the ancient necropolis beneath the city, or in search of the miraculous life-extending bitter sacrament. But now, the terrible sorrow plague has ravaged the city, striking down rich and poor alike. While most victims simply die in agony, a small percentage are instead twisted into bloodthirsty ghouls. As if that were not enough, during the chaos of the plague, a terrible fire swept through Harrowmire, killing thousands and leaving much of the city in ruins. Was that fire accidental? A coincidence? Or caused by someone? In the face of the plague, the fire and the inability of the city militia to control the situation, Harrowmire has been sealed off from the rest of the Empire. The mountain passes that lead to the city are now guarded by Imperial troops under orders to stop anyone leaving. Inside Harrowmire, the situation is dire. Disease and crime run rampant, as those who remain spend their days in wild abandon and their nights in mindless fear. The people have been damned by their empress, abandoned by their god, and cursed by their home. Come nightfall, the citizens of Harrowmire bolt their doors, bar their windows, and pray for daylight. For at night, when the moon hangs low, the monsters rule Harrowmire. In this role-playing game, The protagonists are hunters. They are individuals from across the Empire who have had a brief, traumatic encounter with the forces of darkness. This encounter has left each hunter with a lasting mark, which simultaneously grants them a boon and a curse. A character's boon is a useful ability which will help them on their quest. Their curse is an inescapable doom, which will slowly consume them and seal their fate. Each hunter also has access to several edges, both mundane and supernatural. In a typical game of When the Moon Hangs Low, you will encounter horrors, mystery, and battle. Hunters seem to be drawn to each other, either by fate or simple practicality, aiding each other in their quests. They often congregate at the Bastion, an abbey at the edge of the city, where they can pick up contracts from various organizations within Harrowmire. These contracts can range from hunting the monstrous creatures that skulk in the shadows of Harrowmire, to solving crimes for the beleaguered city militia, or other tasks to help stabilize the city in the wake of the plague. The game does a great job in combining action and the gothic elements, so the situations will be quite gloomy and macabre. But because of the extraordinary abilities of the player characters, there could be some cinematic moments. However, as it is often the case, you may encounter things that surpass your capabilities, so do not hesitate if you need to run away. Now, let's talk about the core rules. You play this role-playing game using six-sided dice. It is recommended that each player and the game master has a handful of six-sided dice. The core rules are intended to be easy to learn, and also help capture the action-adventure feel of the game. All characters have three primary statistics, which describe their innate physical, mental, and social abilities. These stats are rated numerically from 1 to 5, with the human average falling around 2 in each stat. Stats of 5 are extremely rare, and represent someone who is at the peak of human achievement in that particular area. Physique is a measure of a character's physical strength, agility, and general constitution. Intellect shows a combination of their intelligence, common sense, and general reasoning power, as well as governing how sharp your senses are. The presence stat combines a character's charisma, empathy, and force of personality. There are also derived stats, such as health, which is an abstract measure of how much damage a character can sustain before they start getting really hurt. They may eventually die if they suffer too many injuries, of course. Resolve is an abstract measure of a character's willpower, mental fortitude, and spiritual strength. Characters use resolve to activate edges, but it is also lost when they confront awful creatures or are witness to disturbing sights. If a character runs out of resolve, their curse will become more severe, until it completely consumes them. You also have skills, of course. Stats represent a character's innate abilities, but skills represent a character's learned proficiencies and knowledge. A character can have a skill at one of three levels: untrained, trained, and mastered. All characters begin with every skill as untrained. Any character in When the Moon Hangs Low can attempt a check against any skill regardless of their proficiency. However, characters who are trained in a skill will find it much easier to succeed. Characters who have mastered a skill will find it easier still. Let's talk about skill checks. These are made by rolling six-sided dice, one for each point in the stat associated with the skill, and counting the number of successes rolled. So this is a dice pool system, where you won't roll too many dice. For example, if you have a relevant attribute of 3, you would only roll 3 dice. So how does a skill factor into this situation? Well, when using an untrained skill, a success is any die that rolls 5 or a 6. If a character is trained in a skill, then the success is any die that rolls a 4, 5 or 6. If a character has mastered a skill, then a success is any die that rolls 3, 4, 5 or 6. For a skill check to be successful, the number of successes in a roll must equal or exceed the difficulty value set by the game master. So for example, if it's a difficulty value of 3, you would need 3 successful dice. However, through the use of special tools, roleplay, or due to beneficial circumstances, you could get bonus dice to roll for this. However, sometimes penalty dice are applied if the circumstances are not in your favor. These are dice that are rolled. If any penalty die results in a 5 or 6, it cancels out one success rolled on the normal skill dice. You can also carry out opposed skill checks. Sometimes two characters come into conflict with each other when making skill checks. In these situations, the difficulty value of a skill check is not determined by the game master. Instead, the characters both make skill checks and the results are compared against each other. In most opposed skill checks, there will be an active character and a passive character. The active character is the one making the skill check and the passive character is the one they are trying to beat. The active character must equal or exceed the result of the passive character's skill check in order to succeed. If the passive character fails to get any successes, then as long as the active character gets a single success, that character succeeds. If neither character gets any successes, they both fail. So an example of an opposed skill check would be combat. There are going to be consequences of failure, of course. Depending on the task in question, failing a skill check can be anything from inconveniences to life-threatening consequences. The results of a failure are not always dangerous. Sometimes tools can be lost or broken. Precious time can be wasted, or valuable ingredients can be consumed and need to be gathered again. Depending on the task, a character may attempt to retry a failed check, but only if they do something to change the circumstances under which they made the first check. This can include using a piece of equipment they hadn't used previously, enlisting the help of an ally, taking some time to rethink their approach, etc. There are also knacks. Some people are just innately better at a particular skill than others. Every character in When the Moon Hangs Low has 3 knacks. These are attached to 3 separate skills at which the character naturally excels. When using a skill they have a knack for, a character adds 2 additional dice to their roll. So as you can see, there is a nice balance where you throw a handful of dice that are modified by your expertise, by the circumstances, by the tools that you employ, etc. And this concludes this part of the review for today. In the next part, we are going to talk about character creation and the marks that both bless and curse the player characters. Thanks for watching this part of the review. If you have any comments or questions, please let me know. And thank you so much to those of you that have been supporting the channel by sending drive-through RPG gift certificates. If anyone else wants to further support the channel, the information on how to do that will be in the description below. Once again, thank you and see you later.